Do you want a bear piss?
Yeah, I could go for another bear piss.
Hey guys, welcome to Meow Club Magic. I'm playing Bant Planeswalkers, and Hentai Jeff is playing.
Black, white, and cat zombies.
Yeah.
Best kind of zombies, right? Not those fancy mono black ones they're playing in these strange like tournaments.
Expensive zombies.
Well, what's in there? Expensive zombies.
Well, you know.
Habitat?
No, he's not in there.
Really?
I'm surprised actually. He is a bit slow, it's really fast. It's like. What's that? Wandering something? It's a one mana black zombie.
What, the scarred card makes zombie?
No, he can keep coming back. He enters tapped, he's a 2-1.
I still don't think he's
wandering
that good.
Wandering dead. Well, he's gone up in price a lot. It's like 3 or 4 quid each.
3 or 4 pence each.
Have you got
one?
I need
to roll. No. I know you do. 18.
Damn it, I think I've drawn too many cards. No, I haven't. That's perfect. Great hand.
I'll keep.
Okay. You're first.
So much eh. Oh, wait, no, I don't draw. That would have been a big mistake. There we go. That's all. Eh.
Uashra Cultivator.
Eh.
Go.
That is all.
Go.
We'll do a curse. That's all.
Yeah, that's gone up loads in price as well.
It's probably a good thing I got mine early.
How much were they?
Quite cheap. They were only probably like 2 quid.
2 quid each?
Probably.
Well, that's quite a lot. They're not that much now.
I don't know how much they were.
It's a lot for an uncommon though.
Oh, they probably weren't that much for an uncommon. How much were they now in price?
About a quid each.
Yeah. Tap one. Cartouche.
Mm-hmm.
Swing.
How much is it?
3.
No blocks.
No talent. Fingers crossed. Hoping to draw a specific card.
Kiora.
Eh.
Swing.
Yeah.
And I'll put a counter on her when it hits you, and then I'll plus one her to untap this and
a land.
This. Go.
Bullshit. So much bullshit. Ugh. Stop.
Mm-hmm.
I don't need to have a tap counter because they don't tap. Both swing at Kiora. And the 1-1 warrior token.
Okay.
So you got 6 damage heading at Kiora.
I'll block that.
Mm-hmm.
Take four.
Yep.
My turn.
Mm-hmm.
Plunderer.
Mm-hmm.
Oath of a journey. Combat.
Yeah. I can't block it. You're aware of this.
Yeah, take three then. And then, whom should I stick it on? I'll stick it on her again, and then I'll plus one her to untap him. And this land and pass turn. What were you saying about that deck where you got screwed with land?
This deck just screws me for land. It has 24, and it either gives me either none or too much. Had I had one more land, it would have been completely fine. This deck now means I've probably lost this game.
Attacking. Scooping. Drinking.
Thinking. Finish.
Okay.
Realistically, all I can do.
Passing turn?
Yeah.
I'll play Dovin Barn.
My hand would have been so good had I had one land.
Swing for three. Put a counter on her. Plus one her. Plus one Dovin.
What's Dovin do again?
Minus three to that.
Okay.
Not three, 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 yeah. Zero. And your turn.
Tap three. Morbid curiosity. Draw three.
Mm-hmm. Is that equal to its power?
Convert mana cost.
Oh.
courtyard. That's all I can do, again.
Spire of Industry.
I haven't found any land, and Warby Curiosity gave me 3 land. It's so kind. So kind. I hate this deck.
Oh, plus one, actually. Or minus one, dove in. I gain 2 life and draw a card. Ooh. Play Sigarda. Swing. Plus one her.
If I don't top deck a certain card, I'm just grouping.
It's your turn.
Scoop. I kept my hand, because if I had 4 land, I had 3 anointed processions. And so I just tank damage for 3 turns, I have 3 anointed processions, get like 16 warriors in 1 turn.
Well, you should have let me make the octopus tokens.
No. Anointed possession only works for me anyway.
Nobody ever lets me get out the octopus tokens, I've got the special tokens and everything.
That's because everyone's just like, when I see you've got the emblem, I just give up. I was just stuck on 3 land, and I had 3 anointed possessions plus a catch of the true in my hand, and she requires 4. No, if I got 4 land, I would have been quite happy, but there's nothing I can do to fix the land in this deck. It's not shuffled.
It is now.
It's still not shuffled. All the cards I just had were on the bottom.
Anointed Procession's worth quite a lot, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
This deck just triggers me. It unintentionally always screws me over. I'm wondering what I could do to change the ways of this deck. What can I put in this to give me cards? I can't know. I put in the black ones, which is like take damage, draw cards.
Sorry, that's a stool under there.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, are you going first?
Yeah, I'm keeping my hand.
Okay.
I've actually got an okay hand. Planes, pass.
Lumbering Falls, go.
Swamp, tap 2, priest.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
Fortified village, reveal the plains.
Mm-hmm.
Skyship plunderer.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
My turn?
Mm-hmm. I love Skyship plunderer. It's probably my favourite blue card.
Combat?
Yep.
Swing 1?
Yep.
Tap 3? Plague Belcher?
Yep. Oh, you did the combat first.
No, no way.
I'll play Forest Ooh, Ashra Cultivator.
Mm-hmm.
Swing for two.
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Tap three. Oh. Plague Belcher. Swing for five.
Mm-hmm.
That's all. Cradle of the Accursed.
Mm-hmm.
Tap five. Liliana's Mastery.
Mm-hmm.
Swing 12.
I'll gang book one of them.
So both of yours die? On the moment,
I'll sack this and get a land.
So just the skyscape dies, and you take six on the other.
Die. Yeah.
Your turn.
I get to put in a land tapped.
You got big plays.
I hope so.
Me, I've got two of each colour and a Cradle of the Accursed. Should I put in the Painted Bluffs instead of the Cradle of the Accursed?
I don't know. I wouldn't really bother for a two colour deck.
It just feels like this deck sometimes. I mean, I don't have Concealed Courtyards. Like, actually, no, aren't I already running some? I feel like I'm already running some. Yeah, I am. This deck just hates me.
I'll play a journey and I'll exile one of your plague belchers. You gain life equal to its power.
So I gain six.
Mm-hmm.
That's your turn. Exile. So up to. Is that all you can do?
Yeah.
Then I win.
Game three.
That's a nice starting hand.
That's one all, isn't it?
Yeah, that was probably a really good starting hand for me. I had two Plague Belchers, I had the Anointed Priest, and it's like, well, I'm just going to sacrifice the Anointed Priest to get two powerful Plague Belchers.
Are you thinking of building mono black zombies?
No.
I probably will, with two lilies, a small lily.
I mean, realistically, I could, but, I mean, the deck I've got at the moment, I feel like it almost split into a mono white and a mono black deck. Go mono white. Build it with, build it around getting lots of warrior tokens on the field, and then I can take in Barn or anything which is of a similar variant. You know, get Anointed Procession using Barn, and then split and build a black zombie deck. You know, run four Plague Belcher, four Lord of the Accursed. I feel like I could easily split this deck into two, because as it stands at the moment, it feels like it's, you know, missing something. What do you think? Should I separate the light and dark?
Well, it's expensive if you want to do mono black. Would you need to buy many cards for it?
I'd need to find other cards to fill up the zombie slots.
Yeah. Well, there's plenty of common zombies in Innistrad and...
I guess I'll keep.
I'm going first, right?
Yeah.
Reveal the forest.
Hey, look, a forest.
Do it.
That's all.
Play Lumbering Fools and pass.
Pass.
Port town, reveal an island.
Mm-hmm.
Tap three. Renegade Rallier, so go.
Pass.
You'd never get land screwed if you went mono.
You're right, I wouldn't.
Fortified village. Revealing a forest.
You got a lot of land, haven't you? I can relate.
Dove in barn.
Yeah.
Plus one with no target. Swing for three. Go. Oh man. I'll play Uashra Cultivator and a Skyship Plunderer.
Mm-hmm.
Swing for three.
Mm-hmm.
Plus one with no target, so you get.
I'll be taking Dovin, please.
Man.
That's all.
Dude, you're gonna hate this.
I probably will.
I'm gonna play Jace. Actually, yeah. Oh man, I was gonna return that to your hand, but then you can just cast it again.
And still Jace instead.
Yeah. Might just do it anyway. Yeah, why not?
Yeah?
Yeah. And then. Do combat. Yeah.
Yeah, something else we should calculate, why not? And the nine.
I'll put a counter on Jace. I'll minus one Dovin to gain two life and draw a card. And I'll pass turn.
I'll take Chase.
Okay. My turn.
Mm-hmm.
Play Tamiyo. I'll minus two her. Tap that, it doesn't untap in your next step. Swing. Five. a counter on Tamiyo.
Mm-hmm.
Plus a minus one Dovin actually. Inspector Thraben. Get a clue and pass turn.
Planes. I have two of them. I'm not going to bother with the die because I can imagine me not living much longer. Okay. That's all. I think this deck probably does need to be split into two decks.
What, are you going to do mono white zombies as well?
Hmm. Mono white zombies slash tokens. I don't know if there's a better way of me getting tokens though.
I'm gonna deploy the Gatewatch. Look at the top seven. Put up to two Planeswalkers into play.
The problem is, if I do that, it means I have to take out start to finish. Because, you know, dual colour card.
Play Kiora. On minus two Tamiyo. To tap your two creatures. And they don't untap. And your next step. Swing. To be fair, that was pretty lucky hands I got the two times I won.
This deck definitely feels like it's not running as it should. Like, it just feels like it's missing something this whole time.
Have you got Binding Mummy in there?
No.
Do you not like it?
No.
I think it's really good.
It's like I don't have Fanbear in here.
Yeah, but Binding Mummy's better. I think I'm going to build white-blue zombies.
It's because half of this deck is built towards making tokens, and the other half is built towards kind of buffing up zombies.
How many Anointed Processions are you running?
Four.
I probably wouldn't run that many.
I'm running probably four because I'm trying to get tokens.
Yeah.
I think it's definitely, I feel like I need to dissect
probably it. Probably need better, more low mana plays.
I definitely feel like I need to some... I feel like this is probably a way to split it into two decks. But I feel it'll probably be stronger if I pushed it towards black than if I pushed it towards white.
Yeah, I don't
think... So I could run it with, like, Doom Dissenter.
Yeah, he's really good.
But
then you'd have to get rid of Anointed Procession.
Question.
If you're trading them, I'll take them off you.
Should I put Doom Dissenter? No, because I'd be building two decks. Instead, should I realistically put Doom Dissenter in there instead of True Heart Duelist?
Yeah, I don't actually think he's that good. I thought he was really good when I first saw him, but like.
Because Doom Dissenter.
He's more defensive than aggro. Doom Dissenter is really good. And also, that Festering Mummy is really good. The black one drop is common. And. When it dies, you can give something minus one till end of turn. So that can really stall out the game.
I thought you put minus one counter on it.
Maybe. Yeah, it probably is that. But either way, it can like kill something off. Or
yeah. I think I want to build this deck into two separate decks. One which will be a white Westvale Abbey deck. One which will be a black zombie deck.
Yeah. Actually, people are using Westvale Abbey with the zombies in the Pro Tour, like mono black and black white.
I think, because if I look at this, I'm going to split these down, just ignore them. So I'm going to split it into black and white.